So today on Recalations, hi, how are you?
Yeah,
and actually to all of you, how are you? A very big hi to you and welcome. In this video in chapter 3, we're analyzing the themes in the chapter. We have several themes, actually many as you can see on the board, but I'm going to explain each of them in a very detailed manner to make you comprehend. So, karibu sana. How do you say karibu in Kalenjin? The Kalenjin who's watching, kindly text me. And the first one is education. And Professor Kimani, he studied at the University of Oxford. And we are told that he is a professor at the University of Nairobi. That you are going to check on page 21. Okay, page 21, the first paragraph. Professor Kimani joined the University of Nairobi directly as a senior lecturer. The same paragraph, you learned that he studied at University of Oxford. He is a professor, but he began working as a senior lecturer. Because of his good work, he was promoted. And number two, we have the theme of marriage. Married between Professor Kimani and Asiya Omondi. They met at the University of Nairobi. Page 22, the first paragraph. He did not care. After all his antics in the war that he had started and won, he had also won him the heart of a campus beauty. Her name was Asiya Omondi. He married her on a rainy but approving Saturday, etc. So that supports marriage. Marriage, we have male violence on page 27. Over 2/3 of women in Gambia witness it on themselves or on other women. And that is the reason as to why Tuni and other women had joined a seminar in which the instructor was teaching them the personal safety measures. The instructor, remember, was a woman. Page 27. The first paragraph, but I'm going to begin in the middle. Well, such a precaution against male violence. Over 2/3 of women in this country witness it on other women or on themselves. You can't continue reading the same thing, you're going to understand better. After male violence, have poor leadership. Still, they're going to explain using the same illustration from page 26 to page 27. It is the role of the government to provide safety for the citizens, but we can see that the government has failed to play its role. Now, the citizens are learning their own personal protective or personal safety measures because the government could not provide safety for the citizen or to the citizens. And that is from page 26 to 27, we are explaining how male violence, and let us read page 27, page 26, paragraph 2. Professor Kimani noted, you call that clever, he helps himself to more for Tuni. Safety isn't clever. Things we do by attending seminars, it's a necessity the state should provide to us. You see, the role of the government to provide safety to their citizens, but it has failed. And if it can't, he did not answer. But then you can see Tuni joining a seminar to learn the protective, say, or the safety measures, because the government is not doing that to the citizens. And that can also be termed as betrayal if you explain it in a very good way. After that, we have the theme of betrayal on page 33. We have Newborn Walumu betrayed Professor Kimani. He knew that he was married to Asiya Omondi, but still he asked her to marry him. And word on that, we can say Asiya Omondi betrayed Professor Kimani. her husband by agreeing to marry newborn Walomu. And in addition to that, blamed him for the death of their daughter Tuni. Page 33, we bring that together. We begin from page 32. I'm leaving, she said. The bird creaked. What do you mean you're leaving? Professor Kimani asked. He knew the answer. She did not want to stay with him anymore. He pressed her. What's going on? Newborn has asked me to marry him, she said. You see? Now that is betrayal. And as you proceed reading 33 to 34, she agreed to marry him and she left the following morning. She also blamed Professor Kimani for the death of Tuni. From better we have, from betrayal we have materialism. To an extent, we can say that Asiya Omondi is materialistic. The fact that she is leaving the husband for a richer man who is an MP. And also, the husband, who is Professor Kimani, mentioned, asked the woman, the wife, is it because of his money? Page 33. Newborn has asked me to marry him, she said. This part he did not know. Newborn alone, he asked. Then he sat up in his half of the bed. Yes, he did not wait for her answer. It is his money, isn't it? But I can see down there, the wife saying, I don't know, let me check the number of paragraph. I'm saying, Sia, he slid back into the bed as well. The bed protested that even the rich have their share of trouble, plus more trouble from their wealth. That is Professor Kimani. And how did Asiya answer her? If their wealth were a problem, why don't they simply give it away? So you can see she's materialistic for that matter. After that, we have in polygamy on page 35, and it is newborn Walomu. He'd married three wives, and each of them had born him a child. And now he wants to marry the fourth one, and that is Asiya Omondi. Page 35, in the middle. Was he not husband to three beautiful young women who had already born him a child each? And again, he wants Asiya Omondi. From that we have conflict, that you can say conflict between newborn Walomu and Professor Kimani, because newborn Walomu asked Asiya Omondi to marry him. So there is that conflict that resulted to violence and then making Professor Kimani to be jailed for 6 months and demoted. We also have impunity, and impunity is whereby those in authority are exempted from punishment. In other words, they are found in mistake, but they are not punished. And we have this Sama or Mark Thatcher, who lives in South Africa, and he is a son of a former British Prime Minister, Margaret Thatcher, and he staged a coup in Equatorial Guinea, and the government of South Africa hold him and fined him $1 million in a 4-year jail term, which was immediately suspended. You can check that on page 39. It's a long story, but you can. Sir Mark Thatcher, also known as Mark Thatcher, is the son of a former British Prime Minister, Margaret Thatcher. Yes, you can read. You can read fourth paragraph. Missionary might even be a better word, actually. You see, they believe they were on a mission, but call them whatever you want. My point is, Sir Mark hired them to go stage a coup in Equatorial Guinea. Now, last year, the government of South Africa hold him in and fined him $1 million. Add to that a 4-year jail sentence that is immediately suspended. That is what we call impunity. He's not punished because of his status. We also have corruption on page 41 in form of the bribe, in form of bribery. And yes, so the presidents are the ones who take bigger bribe than the police. Page 41. I get sick, the first paragraph in the middle, I get sick each time I hear presidents telling the police to stop taking bribes. Why should they stop when those who tell them to stop take even bigger bribes? Lastly, we have neocolonialism. After the white man left, we hope that our African leaders are going to lead us well without favoritism. They are going to make our lives better, but that did not happen. In fact, they are the ones who were torturing the Africans and the colonial masters. And we can see that in the book, the poor leadership, the poor government. But there is one that happened in Kenya. MPs, they staged coup to improve their remunerations. And we are told that when Professor Kemani started teaching, professors used to earn more than the MPs. But then they had to change the laws, and now they are earning more, in fact hundreds and hundreds of times than the professors. And to add on that, their income is not taxed. So that is neocolonialism. We can check that on page 23. The parliament staged coup. Yes, and they staged it successfully. Look, the year I was teaching, MPs still earned less. I repeat, less than professors did. Now, each MP takes rates in up to 100 times, repeat, 100 times the innocent professor's weeks. It gets worse. Earnings per professor still consist of salaries which are taxable, whereas earning by MPs are not taxable. That brings us to the end of our lesson today. I hope that you enjoyed. I hope that you have actually learned something that is new and you're going to apply it to your studies. Thank you so much for watching. Let us meet tomorrow or next time in chapter 4. Bye bye for now.